Kevin Bacon, what is that thing? Well, that is a space alien. No? Okay, that's Diaper Genie 2. Dun, dun, dun. But I don't have any little kids around my house. So what in the world can you be using that thing for? Well, let me show you how this thing works, and maybe you'll get the idea. I'm going to grab a walnut. Walnut. We're going to walk up here to this Diaper Genie 2. We're going to step on the little foot pedal. It opens up, and inside, you can see the mechanism, closes a little door. You drop in, well, in original form, the diaper, in this case a walnut, you let go. The walnut falls down inside. Now, I'm not going to collect walnuts with this thing. Man, that would be a real chore. But if you pop it open, there's a rather large lower compartment in here. You install a plastic bag in that lower compartment. You close the top back up, and you have a fruit fly safe indoor compost catcher. Step on the lid, drop in your kitchen waste, let go, and as you see, the little doors close, and the top closes shut, and two things happen. Now remember, this was for diapers. It keeps in the smell very well, and keeps in the fruit flies. And it does such a good job, in fact, keeping in the fruit flies that on the inside of the top portion, there were all kinds of fruit fly eggs that had been laid, but there were none in my house. They did not ever get out of this thing. So, there it is, Diaper Genie 2. I know there was a Diaper Genie 1 at one point. There might be other ones. I got this one at a thrift shop for $2.50. And it holds about 3 gallons of compost. But if you wait that long, you know, you're going to start getting some pretty raunchy smells in your house. But still, I mean, how can you beat that? $2.50, pop the lid, drop it in. It's kid-proof. It's cat-proof. I mean, even if the cats were to get the lid open, they can't get down in there to get at that stuff. They will probably tear the bag up around the outside of it a little bit like they do any other trash can, but as far as involving themselves with whatever goes on inside, once it's in there, it's pretty well safe. Anyway, that's my household tip for today, and when I'm done, I take that bag over here to this compost barrel that I made last summer, and I've been filling this up with rabbit manure and everything else, and it rots down, and it's only about half full, but it's been full about 4 times this summer. So next spring, when I get ready to use this compost, here you can see on the outside edge there, it's rotted down to about 2/3 of the height. When I get ready to use that compost, it's going to be some seriously concentrated stuff. And of course, the runoff from there came down and watered those potatoes that I had. And you know, that's my simple fertilizer system. I set my compost at the top of the garden, the water runs through it and runs the rest. But there it is. Compost Genie. Now, Kevin Bacon, how hard is that thing to clean? Well, I sprayed it down with some soapy water, brought it out here, hosed it down with a hose, took a little bit of a scrub brush to some of the nasty spots, and a bottle brush some of the places on the inside. That's it. 10 minutes, boom, it's done. I wouldn't expect you to have to clean it very often. I actually waited until it had more in it than it came up to that line. But if you emptied it on a semi-regular basis, that thing will be a great thing, and it looks good in your kitchen. And, you know, there you are. Compost Genie 2. Kevin Bacon. Bye for now.